Straight to the deepest secrets of different bills. Hey, don't put them in, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Went from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt. They try to bring me down, see me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, my nephews and nieces? This is your favorite uncle, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, listen, before we get too far in this video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like, and let's get this video to at least 1,000 likes. That'll definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe. I'm by far the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community. Hope you can appreciate the 9 a.m. and that 5 p.m. daily double uploads, and you can show that appreciation by dropping a like and subscribing. Right now, let's get straight into this video. So today, my nephews and nieces, what we're going to talk about is we're going to talk about the 5'7" slasher in NBA 2K22 current gen. This is part of the Ridiculous series. Hopefully, if you've been liking the Ridiculous series, just check out the playlist. I got some really, really cool builds on there, man. Most of them have been over 6'10". Now we're trying to go short and make some smaller builds, but I'm really having fun with this Ridiculous series. And the slasher is one that's really, really dope, because last year you couldn't get contact dunks with a 5'7". But this year, you can get contact dunks with a 5'7", right? Now, you do want to go point guard, because that's how you can be the lowest you possibly can be. Right or left-handed does not matter. In order to get contact dunks, you do need to go with the pure blue, okay? So you need to go pure blue with this. And then we're going to go speed invert, right? You can go speed invert. And the reason why you want to go speed invert is because just by being 5'7", you're going to have like 99 everything. But if you go here, like on balance or anywhere else, you just won't get 99 everything. This right here will give you 99 on everything, all right? And then what you want to do here is you want to max out your close shot, your driving layup, and your driving dunk, okay? For 28 badge upgrades, all right? Finishing badge upgrades. Then what you want to do is max out your mid-range, your three-point shot, your free throw, and your post-fade for 11 shooting. Then you want to max out your pass accuracy, your ball handling, and then go 65 to get you right at 17 playmaking badge upgrades. And then at 5'7", all you need is just your perimeter, your lateral quickness, and your steal. You only get one badge, but guess what? This is all you're going to get because you're 5'7", right? You don't need block. You don't need offensive rebound. You ain't getting none of that, right? Now, so it makes no sense to put attributes in there. So this is one of the few times where you're perfectly fine going this route, all right? And then what you want to do is this, all right? Your body type, you actually want to go ahead and go compact, right? And I'm going to show you why. Go compact. Go all the way down to 5'7", right? You see how everything says 95, 95, 95, right? So go 5'7", but then just go ahead and max your weight out. It doesn't matter. It doesn't affect anything. It just adds more strength to you. So why not, right? Just add more strength. Then what you want to do with your wingspan, you want to max it all the way out. And as you can see, it gets you to 82, all right? So now let's just talk about a few things. You do know you get a +8 to your physicals. But the big thing is that obviously you're already going to have the 99. Even when you hit 99 overall, you have the 99 speed and all that type stuff, right? But you do get the additional +8 by obviously going to the my career, playing every single game until you become a starter. Once you become a starter, then what you want to do is go ahead and sim out the rest of the regular season, play every playoff game, win the championship, and then you'll get the gym right badge, okay? B, what you can do is just go to the Gatorade facility, talk to the guy in the entrance. He'll give you a quest, which just say, hey, just hit level 40 in any season. Once you hit that 40 in that season, you'll get the gym rat badge, right? Then, of course, C, which a lot of people do, is just every 4 days, head to the Gatorade facility, get a +4 in these workout, and then obviously you will get the +4. So, again, like I said, it doesn't matter in this instance because you're going to already have 99 just by hitting 99 overall. But just say, for instance, if you needed 8, obviously you'll have to do one of those 3 quests, okay? But now on the left, the finishing, shooting, playmaking, defensive rebound, you do get a +4 here. And this is how you get contact dunks, because your 82 driving dunk, all you have to do is be a 97 overall. At 97 overall, you'll get to 84. But then you can actually get to 86 driving dunk by being 99 overall. So, but you don't have to worry about it, because once you get, you know, your pro contact dunks, you're going to be Gucci, okay? And then on your shooting, you get a +4 here. So you have a 70 mid-range, you have a 61 three ball, and then you have a ridiculous 80 post fade, which is pretty funny. But the 61 three ball kind of worries me a little bit. Because it's a lot lower than what you would expect, but I think it's because it's pure blue. So that's why I'm just like, eh, I don't know if I really want to say this is a build that you ISO by the top with. This is probably more of a catch and shoot type build if you're not ISOing trying to go to the bucket, okay? And then on your playmaking, you do have an 80 pass accuracy with a ridiculous 92 ball handle. You'll be able to momentum dribble with this build, of course. You'll be able to get all the seasonal tier signature packages that have come, because you're obviously you're under 6'4". You have an 85 or higher ball handle, so you'll be able to get all those six. Now, this is what's really dope. Look at this defense. 82 perimeter defense, 78 lateral quickness, and a ridiculous 92 steal. Do y'all see that? You get a 92 steal with this build. Like, that is unheard of to even think about, that you get a 92 steal with this build, right? So now, obviously you have playmaking and slash and take, but you gotta go slasher with this, all right? And then here you have it, my nephews and nieces. The 5'7 comes out as a two-way slasher, okay? So now, of course, you got spud web at the top, which is pretty dope. Now let's do this. We're gonna test this build out real quick. We'll get the 99, and then of course we'll get you out of here. So let's do this, give him 99, boom. Now, the big ones here is this. You wanna get Fearless Finisher, you wanna get Posterizer, you wanna get Slithery, and you wanna get Limitless Takeoff, okay? Those are gonna be very important, but now all of a sudden you wanna get Giant Slayer, right? You wanna get Acrobat, and then you have four left over. Now let's look at some of these badges here and see what we need. Fast Twitch, speeds up standing layups or dunks around the rim. We don't need that. Hook Specialist, Grace Under Pressure, we don't need that. Postman Technician, we don't need that. Mouse in the House, gives a boost on layups to the opponent's much smaller. We're about as small as it gets, all right? Lob City Finisher, right? Improves the chances of completing a successful alley-oop or dunk. Do we really want that? I don't know, right? But then we have something here. Put back, teardrop, and unstrippable, right? Unstrippable, you can get away with that by just going on bronze. Put back boss, if you want to get put back dunks with a 5'7", yeah, who don't want to get a put back boss with a 5'7"? So I'm going to go with that on bronze also. And then I'm going to surprisingly put silver teardrop, increase the chance of hitting floaters and runners. I think that'd be pretty fun. So this is what I would go with for my finishing, okay? And on the shooting, this is where things can get pretty tricky. But what I think would be the best bet is obviously you do want to go sniper, but you want to get catch and shoot, right? Because this will give you an opportunity when you pass the ball to be able to get it back and be able to shoot with it. I just don't know if there's enough here to do this. Hot zone hunter, sniper, stop and pop, and then maybe like mismatch expert and lucky seven or something like that, right? I don't know. So this was something you have to mess around with. I will be making this build though, so obviously I will follow up with you on this. And then here, of course, you wanna go Hannah's for days, quick first step, quick chain, hyperdrive. I gotta have my tight handles. I wanna get unpluckable on silver. And then from here, I'll go bail out and bullet passer, okay? Just to top it off. This is what I'll rock with here. And then on the defensive side, what I would do is I would just go interceptor and call it a day, all right? So there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the ridiculous 5'7 slasher build. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, just make sure you drop a like, you subscribe to the channel, and as usual, your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon on the Banger Man, and you know, when I say I'm back soon on the Banger, you know exactly what day I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.
If he call for a low, we gon' give it to him. Take the stop off the top of no transformer. Man, we're ducking and dodging on that corner. Doing flip with a beat like a mighty morpher. Told myself to get rich and go help.